Howdy, howdy. This is your RPG chick. Cue the maestro. We are here in the Chez Le Ogre. I'm going to talk to Headmaster Block. Why, I have no freaking idea. I need to talk to the two-headed ogre bartender from the original game. I'm going to talk to Remi, the swashbuckling king of thieves type ratty personality. Also from the original game.
Hello, Headmaster Block.
Weathervane, haven't you got things to attend to at school?
I'm sort of still on the job. I'm just getting some tools from the town.
Fine. I have to admit that your performance today did not disappoint me.
Really?
I didn't expect anything. Thus, I was neither surprised nor disappointed that your results do not look good when compared to those of a qualified specialist.
What? The problems you set me are impossible.
I think that you're unfairly giving me difficult tasks just so I can fail at them, and then you have an excuse to get rid of me.
Oh, I could get rid of you with very simple tasks, Weathervane. It's not your fault. You shouldn't have been put in a position in which you are confronted with tasks that are beyond your schooling and your abilities.
Well, okay, what exactly are you doing, if I may ask?
What are you doing there, if I might ask? Surely you can't earn that much gold as a school headmaster, right?
Of course not. The gold is for the council leader's election campaign. I'm her party treasurer.
Yeah, of course.
Some people want the council leader to win the election very badly.
Of course. They see their donation as an investment in the future, and they know how to make a difference.
Have to be going.
I'll be expecting you tomorrow after the opening ceremony for a staff appraisal meeting, so we can talk about your performance.
Very well. My golem and I are going to show you.
Right.
He's unfair to me and pretends he isn't. I'm only going to talk to him if I have to.
Okay. I'd like a drink, please. I remember these guys did like drinks. Or the smart one does, actually.
Hello!
Little mini man!
But Blout, that's a guest! Welcome, noble sir. How can we help you?
Yep, I definitely remember them. Should I say you or you too?
You're a two-headed ogre, right?
Well, I am an ogre.
And me too.
So, you two are ogres.
My name is Zloth, mage, philosopher, scholar.
And bag of wind.
That is Blout, my brother. He is...
Me, Basher! Me, bash things up!
Does the pub belong to you two, or do you just work here?
Do you own the inn?
I bought it. Blout is just my employee.
Blout bought too!
Yes, but then you lost your half at poker. Now it all belongs to me.
Blout not give you his half. Blout best laugh if he tried to take away.
If you touch me, I'll have you thrown in jail.
That'll definitely work. You get your alcohol from Bill, right?
I have heard that you buy your alcohol from Bill.
We don't have much choice. He's the only trader who'll sell us alcohol.
Expensive!
You're right there. The prices are unashamedly high.
Why is Bill the only trader who sells alcohol?
Seastone is a big town with lots of merchants. Why is Bill the only one selling alcohol?
Since the town was virtually besieged with refugees, there's been no way for the farmers and traders from the surrounding areas to get through with their ox carts.
Right. And Bill gets his supplies by air. Just the same, there's still more than one merchant in the upper town, isn't there?
Of course. Bill trades alcohol, another trades in lamp oil, the next one in mana potions. That way they avoid competition and set any price they want.
I smashed them all!
We are upset about it.
I see that. Let's come back to that. Do you get one or two votes in the election?
Are you allowed one or two votes in the election?
One would think that as we have two voices, we should also have two votes. Unfortunately, the town council sees things differently.
And who do you want to vote for?
Archmage Alistair, of course.
Council... Mrs. Van Buren. Little woman says how it is.
Blout likes it when things are uncomplicated.
Tax down, more work for all. See stone number one.
But you don't buy it.
I'd also prefer it if our problems were solved quicker. But Van Buren stands for things staying as they are or regressing. Neither has ever helped.
Did someone forget that jacket?
Did someone forget that jacket on the chair over there?
Zoom back.
Oh, it belongs to a young guest. He, well, got into a fight with Mr. Shieldhand of the town guard and was arrested.
Really?
Hooligan! Lock up immediately.
What happened?
He was quietly drinking his beer. Shieldhand came in, recognized him as one of the protesters and wanted to search him. The young man refused, said he hadn't done anything wrong and wouldn't let anyone search him without reason.
Then bang! Drenched in lockdown!
And the jacket?
It's been hanging there ever since. We're keeping it as a deposit until he's paid for his beer.
You know anything about constructing golems? I was going to say golems again.
If you're a mage, Lof, do you know how to build golems?
I've never tried.
You have? Tried long time to build golem. Just too stupid.
That's completely untrue. That was just playing around.
So, I want to build a golem, and I know the right incantation. Can you help me build one?
No. I don't want anything to do with it.
Psst, Weeber.
Yes?
What are you whispering about? I don't like whispering behind my back.
How's it going to whisper behind your back?
Oh, was eavesdrop.
Do you and Blout have many secrets from one another?
Do you and Blout keep many secrets from each other?
Not particularly. I just don't like it when Blout fiddles about behind my back. It usually ends in catastrophe.
Maybe you're too hard on him.
He was going to juggle with kitchen knives this afternoon. I noticed just in time.
Would have worked.
No, it wouldn't. And they are my fingers, too.
Zloff tell Blout off. Zloff always annoyed.
With good reason. The pub, all this work. And on top of all that, I have to play babysitter. I lost track of time with all that ranting, and now I've missed the bakery. All your fault, Blout.
What did you want from the bakery?
The bakery up by the guardhouse? I go there myself.
Oh, they have those wonderful chocolates. I treat myself to one or two every night.
You see, Sloth got fat.
First of all, that's not true. And secondly, it's flab born of frustration because I have to put up with you.
Do you guys realize you have the same body? I could sort out a barrel of brandy for you. Interested?
Would you perhaps be interested in a barrel of brandy? I'm sure that Bill would deliver today.
No, thank you. We still have stock, and we have much fewer guests since the barricade was erected.
But I need a password.
The password for Bill's crane capers? If you were one of his trustworthy customers, you'd know it.
I am. I just forgot it. I could help you get one over on Bill.
How about we try and bring down Bill and his exorbitant prices?
What are you thinking of?
Bashing?
Well, let's just say I could put the long arm of the law onto him.
Shield hand?
Tin man.
I don't know.
The plan is absolutely Anton-proof. We're all set. I just need Bill's password and bam! We have him by his muttony legs.
And it won't be traced back to us? I really don't want to be paying even more for our alcohol in the future.
It's a secret covert operation shrouded in secrecy.
Shrouded in secrecy?
He has earned it. Oh, all right then. The password is gold won't make you happy.
That's more than one word.
Here, a bag of silver for the brandy. It will be worth it if it scuppers business for Bill and his band of ne'er-do-wells.
Thanks. Then take care, you two. One. Both.
So long.
Bye.
Bye.
A bag of silver for Bill's keg of brandy. That is more than an honest tradesman earns in a month.
Bash him. Bash. Clean place. Okay. Alright, let's talk to...
Hello, Blout.
Willy Burr.
Oh, okay, we got good... more stuff to say, okay. Are you really going to work... vote for Van Buren?
Are you really sure you want to vote for Van Buren?
Little woman with big hair knows what, has lots of gold and lots of success.
And you believe that if she's elected, you'll get the same?
Sure, promise.
Fine. But I think the little guy is better off with Archmage Alistair.
Me not little. And when Blout sued rich and powerful, little people shouldn't take away his money.
I used to work in a pub, too.
Before I became a mage, I worked in a dwarven inn in the Whitebridge Mountains.
All right, yeah, very
you
beginning.
You have stupid boss, too.
I am not stupid.
Blout always have to work much more than Zloth.
That's because you're so clumsy. We do the same amount of work. I might even do a little bit more.
In too much work. No free time.
Psst. What was it you wanted to tell me that Sloth shouldn't hear?
Psst. Blout. What did you want to tell me?
I won't say.
You're whispering again.
If we talk now, does Sloth hear us?
Oh. Just stop whispering behind my back, all right.
Okay, sorry. Want non-alcoholic drink as apology?
Oh, no. You might have tricked me with alcohol once, but never again.
So Blood got you plastered?
Sloth get exhausted from itchy-bitchy symbol of alcohol. Sloth like little girl with pigtails.
I have alcohol intolerance. Or perhaps an allergy.
But yet you like your cocktails. Can't you just tell me what you wanted to say, Blout?
What did you want to tell me, Blout?
No, Sloth eavesdropping. I say nothing while Sloth listening.
Well, how are you supposed to get away from him?
I'm not going anywhere.
Obviously.
What did you want to tell?
No, I...
Bye, Blout.
Bye, Blout.
Bye!
Talk to Sloth. No, he's the other way.
I don't need to talk to Sloth at the moment.
Alright, then let's talk to Remi. First, let's look at Remi, I guess.
Remi looks tired. I think the election campaign and the current situation in the town are really taking their toll on him.
Hi.
Hello, Remi.
If it isn't the magic school's new star professor, how was your first day, Wilbur?
Busy. Headmaster Block is very, very mean to me.
Master Block is very mean to me. He gives me loads of difficult tasks.
All of which you've solved, knowing you.
Almost.
Yes. But then he gives me new tasks that are even more difficult. And even if I worked through the night, I still couldn't finish them all. No one could.
Interesting and curious. If he wanted to represent you as the Archmage's bad choice, then he wouldn't have given you exercises that are clearly impossible. People would realize what kind of game was being played, and the trick would backfire. Did you notice anything else?
Yeah, I noticed that you look very strung out, Remi.
You don't look all that happy yourself. Tough day.
Tough week. I'm worried about the Archmage's safety. The situation in the town is explosive. He was heckled on the street while checking up on a field hospital down there. But it was just some wound-up idiots. I'm worried about the one assailant who has enough brains, resources, and volition.
Someone? Like Headmaster Block?
Hard to imagine, but it can't be ruled out. We need more information.
The magic slate recommended I build a golem. What do you think of that?
Archmage Alistair gave me a magic slate.
That's just like him. He likes magical playthings.
That's not all. The slate advised me to build a golem to help me with my work.
A golem?
They're very strong, so it could help me with a lot of my work.
Yes, but I was thinking of something else. Think about it. We agree the Archmage is the most powerful living wizard.
Of course.
No one could touch a hair on his head with a magical attack. But brute force, a stone to the head, a knife in the ribs.
That could be a possibility.
But now imagine that he had a bodyguard, a big chap, hard as stone.
I know this isn't the answer, but you mean me?
You mean me? Sure, I've grown a bit, but I don't feel that powerful, and I'm not that tough.
No. I mean a golem.
Ah, okay. I get it.
Even a troll wouldn't get past a golem. Best of all, golems are absolutely loyal. They simply cannot help but follow their master's commands.
And if I order it to defend the Archmage with its life?
Then that's exactly what it'll do, and no one would get past it.
That sounds fantastic.
Can you manage that? Building a golem and bringing it to life?
I'll sure try, at any rate. I'll get it to complete the headmaster's stupid tasks first, and then guard the Archmage.
The headmaster and the council leader have come up against the wrong gnome.
Well, I got two reasons to build this thing. By the way, you were asking about anything else. I saw something suspicious.
I surprised Headmaster Block in the staff room as he was rummaging through a desk drawer. But he was startled when I spoke to him, like I caught him doing something.
He didn't want you to see him fiddling around in his own desk drawer.
Interesting, isn't it?
At first there was the unsolvable exercises, and now the desk drawer. Something's not right.
Well, there's two of them.
That's what I think, too.
After he left again. So, it's like someone forgot that they weren't disguised as Headmaster Block and was like, whoa. I bumped into Council Leader Van Buren again. Did we bump into her again? I don't remember. I thought it was just the one time.
The council leader was standing up by the new lottery.
Oh, right. I remember her. That part.
Addition of the lookout to a reporter.
Yes. She has the lookout under her thumb. She's a horrible piece of work. Ambitious, stubborn, and unscrupulous. A dangerous combination. Comes from a humble background, but got her feet under old Van Buren's table. Tried to persuade him to do all sorts of new business deals and start a career in politics. Many say he died so young because he finally wanted to be left in peace.
How did she end up as the Archmage's most promising challenger?
The Archmage doesn't want the most important posts in government to go automatically to the richest citizens anymore, but rather to the most competent people, chosen by the people.
And of course the nobility and the merchants don't like that one bit.
They were seething when they found out about it, but there was nothing they could do to start with. The Archmage were too popular, untouchable. But then along came Sybil Van Buren, and she had a plan. The election was to be approved and set for 1 year's time. One year in which she put up obstacles in the Archmage's way and sabotaged his politics in any way she could. Her only aim was to make him look bad. By the gods, how I'd loathe it if she succeeded.
Right. Do you think the Archmage will win the election?
But we will win the election, right? The Archmage, I mean.
Van Buren has used all her resources. Powerful, rich friends with important posts at the Seastone Lookout. The only newspaper left in town. Simple slogan, simple solutions, patriotism and resentment. She tells the people what they want to hear. And yet, the Archmage will win the election.
Oh.
Every vote for the council leader and her cronies is a vote too many. But stupidity amongst the voters had not prevailed yet.
Why doesn't the Archmage expose the leader of the council?
Why doesn't the Archmage defend himself more aggressively against the council leader? Why doesn't he just tell everyone about her scheming?
He wants as many people as possible to take part in solving our problems. He doesn't want there to be two sides at each other's throats. But I don't know if it will work. People are starting to accept the conditions. They blame everyone and everything, and they don't even try to change anything anymore. I asked the Archmage about it. You know what he said?
No idea.
He's comfortable having things stay as they are. That's why many favor it. Progress requires effort. What kind of world would it be if there was glaring injustice and everyone put up with it just because change takes too much effort?
Wow.
But hey, I'm just a rat. What do I know?
What are we going to do about Headmaster Block's strange behavior then?
So what do we do now? Keep an eye on Headmaster Block and see what happens?
Show near the elections. A supporter of the council leader behaving suspiciously in the vicinity of the Archmage. No, too risky. We can't wait.
So you're going to have a look for yourself?
Phew, I'd like to, but perhaps that's precisely their plan. An officially unofficial employee of the Archmage sniffing about in the office of one of his political opponents.
Wouldn't be good if word got out. A first-rate scandal. But what about a teacher looking for a form in the staff room? A teacher who is in the school because the headmaster has given him tasks to be done.
Normally I would try to discourage you, but the Archmage is visiting the school tomorrow. If his opponents are planning something, we have to expose them tonight.
I'll do it. I'll have a look around and get back to you if I discover anything.
All right, but be careful, Wilbur.
Then let's not waste any time. I'll build a golem bodyguard for the Archmage and have a look around the headmaster's office.
Good idea. And let me know as soon as you find anything peculiar. No heroics, Wilbur Weathervane.
I'll be careful.
I'll go back underground. I want to find out about the dark magic the Archmage has been sensing for days.
Good luck. You and Van Buren will not succeed with your plan. You may have great and powerful friends, but the Archmage has small and cleverer ones. The jacket belongs to a protester. It has several patches and a badge pinned on the front. No one noticed.
Why do we take that again? Battered pin badge.
The pin that was attached to X's jacket shows a black fist on a red background.
Cast spell.
He's unfair to me. He pretends he isn't. I don't need to talk to Sloth. Hello, Blout.
Willibur!
Bye, Blout.
Bye!
Okay. Oh, we left something here.
Remi left his glass. There's a mark. It says 2CL beside it.
Ah, that's how we're going to measure that.
For most people, that's just a little sip. But for a rat, that's a fair amount of booze, I guess.
Must be really cheap drinks. So you know what we need that for, right?
What can I do for you?
Show me the list.
2 CL. So you guys should put crocodile tears in here.
A small glass with a mark at 2 CL.
That's right. Alright, let's get out of here. Anything new these guys have to say?
Yes?
I'm one of you and I can prove it.
I am one of you. This pin here should be proof enough.
In principle, but perhaps you took it from one of our people under duress.
No, I, earned it. Fair and square.
I'm almost convinced. Show me our secret hand sign and we'll give you the clue.
Oh! Psst! I think I saw the town guard. Better not right now.
Aye. Come back when the coast is clear.
Alright, we gotta find out the secret sign then. Alright.
The fire's melted the ice. Now it's water. The fire is warm and bright.
Sure he is. Oh, how you doing, kid?
That's that terrible boy from class. Pretty late for a little guy like him.
Yeah.
Young guy.
You're past your bedtime. Go see if he's...
Whoa! You're Wilbur Weathervane!
Out to make fun of me, are you? You're probably upset after I proved that I know more about magic than you thought at school this morning.
What? What are you talking about, Master Weathervane?
What is this, his twin or something? Why were you so obnoxious at school this morning?
You were pretty cheeky at school this morning.
Which school?
There you go again, trying to make fun of me.
But Master Weathervane, I'd never...
This morning in the mage school, you were trying to make me feel uncomfortable and look stupid in front of the other students.
The mage school? In the upper town? I'm not even allowed there. I wasn't born in Seastone, and I'm certainly not important enough to enter the upper town without a good reason.
You mean to tell me you weren't in my class this morning?
In your class? To become a wizard? That would be so cool!
Have you got a twin brother?
I still believe you're trying to make fun of me. Or, do you have a twin?
Not that I know of, Master Weathervane. Hey, perhaps someone was controlling my thoughts without me realizing.
Now I'm sure you're trying to make fun of me.
No, it is possible. Not all of the sorcerers, necromancers, and lawyers in the Shadow Army were captured, right?
And lawyers. What are you playing?
You look like you're training for an important battle.
Oh, I meant, what are you talking about?
I'm reenacting your battle. How you and Captain Bonnet and Princess Ivo defeated the Arch-Witch, Mortroga, in the Black Tower.
Oh, really?
It must have been the greatest battle of all time. The solitary heroes, surrounded by monsters, standing up to the leader of the Shadow Army and her son, Munkus. Boom, bash, jah!
Well, maybe it wasn't quite that dramatic.
10 years of war, the artifact of divine fate, and suddenly, peace. What's not dramatic about that?
I got a point there. What do you know about the artifact of divine fate, though?
Do you know what the artifact of divine fate is?
It can fulfill your every wish. I bet you wished for evil to be defeated. Right, Master Weathervane?
We never used it. The Archmage warned us that the artifact was just too powerful.
But if you can wish for anything, why not just wish for good things?
Archmage Alistair doesn't believe the world works that way, and I trust him.
If that's what you think, then I think that too.
Isn't it time you got back home?
It's getting late. Isn't it about time you went home?
I'll wait until all the guests have left the tavern. Sometimes Zloff and Blout give me a room, if no one is renting it.
You don't have a real home?
I've got lots of homes. Sometimes I sleep down in the tent city, and sometimes Widow Twanky lets me sleep on the bench in front of her fire. But if I can sleep in a real bed, in the pub, then of course I'd prefer that.
If you like, you can come with me to the upper town.
I have a small room in the school. If you can't find a bed in the guest house, you're welcome to sleep at my place. My rabbit sheep won't be able to defend his bed in his usual manner, and I can sleep on the floor.
That would be... wow! But the school's in the upper town. I'm not allowed to go there.
Ah, silly rules. Maybe you'll win the lottery.
Which lottery?
There's a lottery tomorrow. The winner gets to live in the upper town.
That will be fantastic!
Maybe you'll get lucky. Everyone has an equal chance.
I'm sure to win. And if not today, then perhaps next time.
Supposedly.
It was good to see you again, or met you for the first time.
There's no way I would have forgotten if I'd met you before, Master Weathervane.
Either the boy's making fun of me, or that's another item from our list of strange events.
You okay?
I'll let him keep on playing. He still has some dragons to save and princesses to kill. Vice versa, of course.
Right. Talk to Bill. I know the password.
Psst! Bill! So, Petey, what's the password?
Gold can't buy happiness.
As long as it's jangling in someone else's purse. Absolutely right. So, you wanted a barrel of brandy.
Right.
That'll be a small bag of silver.
I got that. See, it wouldn't matter that we didn't have the password.
Barrel of brandy coming up.
Because we didn't have the silver then either.
That's it. That's the barrel with the bark.
Right.
What did you say?
Nothing.
Nothing. Just thanks for the delivery.
As long as you pay, I deliver. Take care.
Bill didn't pay any taxes on that barrel. And those taxes build roads, care for the sick and elderly, and pay for my apple. Shieldhand won't be impressed.
Yeah, I said I really appreciate art.
Sloth paid for that barrel fair and square, so it belongs to him. He should collect it before it disappears.
Oh, you mean we can't even take it? Let's go back. Should call an episode, but I want to see how this wraps up here. Oh!
Hello, Sloth!
Reporter's there.
Ah, Wilbur. Greetings.
Part one of our barrel plan worked.
Bill delivered the barrel without paying tax on it.
And that's supposed to cause him problems?
Mr. Shieldhand is arresting him right now. Or talking to him. Or something.
We didn't complete
those
the
two don't
thing.
Particularly like each other, but they are dependent on the same people. They wouldn't, Blout.
Bash each other?
No.
Bite the hand that feeds.
Right.
Ah, if only I was there. Then I could make sure they played by the rules. See you, Sloth.
So long.
But we're not done yet.
Hello, Blout.
Willibur.
We didn't finish the whole plan.
Bye, Blout.
Bye.
He's unfair to me.
Sure is. Alright, stay tuned for the next episode. We'll talk to the reporter. Thanks for watching. See you next time. And a bang bang boogie, and don't stop the boogie.